Hi everyone, Grant Kay here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. In this video, I'll show you how to import a vector illustration as 3D shapes in action. This can definitely accelerate your workflow if you've been given a graphic element that you need to manipulate in action. If you would like to follow along, click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you are watching a podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. So we'll start off in Illustrator, where I have a vector illustration that I would like to import into Flame Premium. Before we do that, I want to bring your attention to the Layers window. Note that the illustration has been broken down into two main sections with a variety of subsections. Secondly, I'm using naming conventions like body and shield. This structure, as well as naming system, will be carried over into action. Now, in order to prepare the vector illustration for Flame Premium, you need to export this out as an SVG file. This format has been chosen as it's an open standard format that can be exported from most design applications. Go to File and choose Save a Copy. Navigate to a designated folder and give your file an appropriate name. In the Format pull-down menu, you choose SVG. Now click Save. There are a variety of SVG profiles, and you're welcome to try them. But the profile I'm choosing is the SVG 1.1. Please be aware that currently Flame Premium does not support embedding fonts in the SVG. So change the font type to Convert to Outlines. It's also worth mentioning at this point that color gradients are not supported. You can easily retexture the 3D shapes in action, so it's not a big issue. Click OK to confirm the settings. Now let's switch over to Flame Premium and import the SVG file. So in Batch, I am starting off with an action node that is using a white color frame as the background. To import the SVG file into action, you double-click on the Import node in the Action node bin. Change the Format pull-down menu to SVG. You will notice that there is an AutoFit function that will scale the vectors to the size of the composite. This makes it easier to start working with. Otherwise, the vectors will be imported at the size they were created at. However, since the vectors will be 3D shapes, you can scale them to whatever size you want without any quality loss. The DPI option will only come into effect if you have exported the SVG with units of measurement such as millimeters, centimeters, or inches. Navigate to the SVG file and select it. In the result view, you will get the illustration. And in the action schematic, you will get a group node. To move the logo around, you could add an axis to the group, or just select the group node and move it via the object menu. So this brings me to a very good point. If you start rotating the logo, the 3D shapes that make up the illustration are all occupying the same Z space in the composite, hence the expected flickering. If you want to keep the logo flat, just turn off the Z buffer. But I'd like to extrude the 3D shapes to make a 3D version of the illustration, and that should eliminate this issue. So go back to the action schematic and select the group node. Let's take a look at what was imported. Hold the meta button and click on the node to call up the contextual menu. Choose ungroup. So this has created quite a large structure of nodes. To tidy this up, press Alt-T to clean up the action schematic. So this is much better to understand. Panning to the top of the branch is the main axis parent of the entire structure. You will see two connections coming off this node. One connection is the shield, and the other connection is the body. If you explore the rest of the structure, you will be able to identify the sections of the illustration. There are some extra axis nodes which are irrelevant to this illustration, so you can delete them if you want. Now from the structure, you can begin to extrude out the various elements. I suggest using a dual view split so that you can see what is selected as you work through the 3D shapes. Let's start off with the first 3D shape on the left. These shapes all form part of the shield's component. This is the 3D element. I want this to be quite prominent. Set the 3D shape to extrude from the front and set an extrusion value of 20. Moving along, we have a whole load of 3D shapes that make up the compositing muscle text. The reason why there are so many shapes is that an envelope effect was applied to the text in Illustrator. So Illustrator already saw this text as outlines. This is the reason why you have a 3D shape per letter, and not because of the SVG import process in Flame Premium. Regardless, I want to extrude all these letters evenly. Switch back to a full screen action schematic view. Zoom out of the schematic until you can see all the 3D shapes involved in constructing this text. Select and hold the first 3D shape. Now press and hold Shift W for a mimic link. Drag the 3D shape node across all the other matching nodes of the compositing muscle text. So all the properties of this 3D shape will be mimicked in all the other matching nodes. Switch back to a dual view and call up the 3D shape properties. Set the extrusion to front and set a depth of 10. Now let's deal with the larger components of the shield. Pan the action schematic until you see the inner and outer shield 3D shapes. Select the inner 3D shape. I want to extrude this forward, but not over the 3D text. So set the extrusion to front and set a depth of 10. The 3D object has a depth of 20 and the inner shield has a depth of 10. This will give us the correct effect in that area. Select the outer 3D shape. Extruding this forward will cover the foreground 3D shapes, so set the extrusion to back and set a depth value of 10. That completes the shield component. Let's quickly do the body component. Select the 3D shape for the action text object. I want this in line with the shield, so set the extrusion to back and set a depth value of 10. Second last, we have the muscle details. I want this to be slightly raised from the main body shape. Set the extrusion to front and set a depth of 2. Finally, we have the 3D shape of the body. To line this up with the shield, set the extrusion to back and set a depth of 10. Now, if you haven't already done so, go to the Action Node Preferences and enable shading. Go to the top axis of the branch and start rotating the 3D shapes. So that works quite well. You can animate every aspect of the 3D shapes to build the logo together. To make the 3D shapes more interesting, I would like the shield to have a shine to it. Locate the outer fill 3D shape in the action schematic. Select the 3D shape and go to its properties menu. I'll increase the shine value. So when you rotate the 3D shapes, you will see the shine effect applying to the shield 3D shape. One last thing I would like to do is retexture the back and extruded edges of the body 3D shape. Pan over to the far right of the node branch. Here is the fill 3D shape of the body. Select the 3D shape and go to its basics menu. Under the texture header, enable multi-material. You now get object group nodes for the front, extrusion, and back of the 3D shape. We need to assign a material to these groups, and you could texture them. Go to the Action Bin menu. Drag out a material node and attach it to the extrude and back nodes of the 3D shape. You can now define the color of the material, or you could use external diffuse maps, or even action substance textures to texture the 3D shape. So now you have your vector illustration as part of your 3D composite. You could reveal it with a G-mask, fly it around the composite, relight it, or use any other functionality available in Action. Coming soon, 3D shapes using open splines and edge gradients. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos.